I just realized something that we have an issue with the dog because we moved our block off center. Now, when the block falls off, the Y position is only minus 161. So if you have the same problem, there are different ways of you could have centered the dog and the block, so you might not have this problem. But you need to make sure that you're broadcasting fallen off when the dog, I mean, sorry, when the block gets down here. So at the moment, the block is on the edge of the screen at minus 161. So I changed if Y position is less than minus 160, broadcast fallen off, and wait. Now, when I receive fallen off, stop other scripts in Sprite. I've deleted the message because we would like to do something a little more interesting when the game ends. And what we're going to do is we're going to hide our dog, and we're going to display another sprite, which is a dog, and he's going to make a noise. So if we go back to our dog, dog works the same way. We can also receive the broadcast message. So when I receive fallen off, I'm simply going to hide him, so you won't see him. So let's test that. Block here, jump, and then boom, our dog disappears. So let's go back to our dog. Run the game. I'm nervous without seeing him. We're going to create a new sprite, which will be our, let's take the same dog two, and now he's called dog three. And yeah, why not have him appear like this? So from the beginning, first of all, let's select costume three like that. And then we'll have on start. When you click start, we're going to hide him. So hide. And then when the game's over, so when we receive that broadcast message, we're going to show. Well, first we'll have him go to, actually. Let's have him go to the block. Go to the player. Then we're going to show him. And perhaps we will have him say something. Let's see. Fence. Let's make him make a sound. Play sound. Oh, apparently there's a sound here. Dog one. I wonder what that makes. So let's run this program. Go there. And he barks. Okay, so he falls off, he makes that face, he gets bigger, and he barks. You can record your own sound or do whatever you find interesting when the game is over. So let's also go back to the player to tidy this game up a little bit. Now the player, we don't want to we don't want the player to we don't want to see this player block. We just want to see the dog. So if we go to the player code and we say when clicked, we want to set our ghost effect. You could also hide him, although that was causing issues for me earlier. So let's see, we can set ghost. So when the game starts, we'll set ghost to 100. I think that should make him invisible. So run the game, and oh, now you can't see the block. So, okay, at this point, you should have all the tools to start making a game. Next week, we will, for the final week, we will experiment with putting obstacles, which you already know how to do, putting targets, which you know how to do, and making a platform that is more interesting than this simple testing platform. Of course, if you really get into this, you can not only make a more interesting platform, but you can make multiple costumes, and each costume for this platform can be its own level. We'll cover some of that next week, but this class ends next Friday. So you are welcome to get started with whatever you would like to make this project the best game you think it can be. Thanks very much.